through the fire. I'll keep burning on. Well, I'll hold myself together when it all goes wrong. The fires, they keep burning on. Well, I'll hold myself together when it all goes wrong. When it all goes wrong. When it all goes wrong, I'll take my time. I'll keep on.
Welcome to 3's the Social.
4's the Party, come on.
Thank you very much for tuning in. You're speaking to myself, Jesse, aka Kevin.
Come on.
The Don Carl.
And me, Eli. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
I don't know why you said it like that.
Say it with his chest in
there. Eli. That's it. Hey, this week was a big week.
Big week,
we released our promo.
Promo.
Got a lot of views. Still getting views.
Still getting views. You know?
If you haven't seen it already, go check it out on the YouTube channel. And that.
You know what I mean? Big track behind the promo as well.
Yeah.
Chasing Status.
Yes. Go on. Drop the vocals.
Should I drop the vocals?
Drop the vocals. We're trying to
push you. Show them what they're missing.
Come on. Would you take a bullet? Would you bite the gun?
Yeah.
Big track, yo. And Carl, they're looking sexy.
I'm looking alright.
Nah, man. Scrap all of that, man. You man did it nice to me.
The cameraman did it nice to the dark guys. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Did it nice to the dark guys. This one here, looking at caramel chocolate.
You know what I mean? Yeah. The London agency's coming in.
Nah, Zoom come, man. Boo-boo, man, been shouting me. Yeah, man, the t-shirt, you know?
We're releasing some exclusive content, you hear that?
Big, boo-boo,
man.
I rate that still. And obviously, that was a big boy interview
big
with Justin.
Interview.
For our first episode as well.
Big boy interview. Like, Justin, yo, he was inspiring, bro.
Oh, truly.
Dropping real anecdotes.
Bro, he was dropping gems, jewels, diamonds. Bro, I felt like, yo.
And from his response, well, I feel like he enjoyed it just as much as we did.
Yeah, exactly.
He was in the zone.
You were just like, he was in awe.
I was in awe.
It's mad. It's like watching like, a Morgan Freeman.
Yeah, like a documentary.
You know when he narrates with his voice. And so he goes on. it was deep still. Yeah, it was good. a deep interview. Like, but what I was going to say is obviously, we're all from Northwest, innit? And it was big way to introduce ourselves. That was like a premiere for us.
Yeah, 100%.
And we released that as a premiere. And you know, he spoke about Northwest. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And we're from Northwest. You know what I'm saying? And that was just nice the way he set the vibe, he set the tone and everything else. Obviously, what did that interview do for you guys? Like, because it did a lot for me. You know what I'm saying? It did a lot for me. Like,
I mean, to me personally, it just opened my eyes, innit? Because obviously, If you put what he's saying into perspective about the area, you're 10 minutes away from each other.
Yeah.
Yet, you've got beef, like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, for
like, obviously, and also just giving us the history of him.
Mm.
Like, just what he got up to, like, his personal journey was interesting because it encapsulated some real heart-wrenching stuff.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
and obviously, He then took us through the journey of redemption.
It's true.
It's true. Not even just to understand his own emotion
and how it led him to
become
a fan of, you know, borders.
Yeah. And the thing that I can relate to is that obviously I've lived in Harlesden for the best part of 20 years. You know what I'm saying? And like he said, I think my thing that I got, the one thing I got from that interview was the fact that, you know, it's humanity. Mm. Has been lost,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
The sense of humanity is gone, you know what I'm saying? Like, we all have a duty of care for the community. We all can contribute in some shape or form, because what Justin is doing, he doesn't have to do it.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
He took that time out
doesn't
of himself
have to, do it. Doesn't
to
have
say,
to do
you know
it.
What, I've seen the issues.
Yeah.
I'm going to try and tackle this myself.
Yeah.
If you don't want to help me, that would be great, because obviously you do need some help sometimes, some backing. And it was surprising when obviously they kind of pulled that funding.
Yeah. It was really surprising. And the thing is, it's like when you think about community, you know, the last bit of that word is unity.
Exactly.
And to think that, you know, that unity.
Look at Eli jumping on that.
Hey, listen,
he said community. Unity.
Justin, change me.
Unity.
You know what I mean? You know, you know, to think that this place used to be unified, he can bop to St. Raph's, he can bop to Stonebridge, he can bop to here and there, you know, and now that's all gone, and that's the sad thing, you know what I'm saying? Obviously, you were raised here, Carl, so what do you think? What do you think?
See, like, I mean, to be honest, that part of me doesn't really understand the kind of the root of all these, that kind of postcode wars and things like that sort of thing. And I agree with you in a sense where, like, it is a community issue, sort of thing, something that the community can do something about. I think a lot of people within the community recognize these issues.
Yeah.
They see them, but then they're waiting for outside help to intervene. Whereas Justin, he's taking it on his own shoulders, you know what I mean? He's like, no, I'm going to do something about this. I'm going to change what's happening.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's what I rate him for that, you know what I mean? Because it's a jump.
It is.
For people to kind of attempt such a thing. And he's doing well with it.
No, he's doing really well. Obviously, like, for me, the first time that I sensed that whole tension between, you know, I don't know, let's say Bridge versus Church Road and that, like, I remember when my mum was just used to be annoying, like, she'll come back from work at 9 p.m, yeah, you know them ones, and she'd be like, hey, Elias, go and buy me some plum tomatoes. I said, yo, it's 9 p.m, who cooks stew at this time, you know what I'm saying? So anyways, I remember, like, I'll go, you know what I'm saying, and you know Peter's Fish Bar, you know where it was, pictures, we'll go there and there'll be bear goons outside, I'll be like, yo, man. So then once you have to pluck up the courage, you know what I'm saying, and try and walk through like a bag of man. Mm. And I remember when I was, I get to the traffic light, I saw about 20 of them, I said, jeez, man. These were the days K-Coke used to hang around and he used to bring his boys in there. And these times I was in like high school, like I'll say secondary school, year 9.
Yeah.
And I'd be walking and then, you know, I had to walk through this crowd of like a bag of man, this crowd. And you know when you're walking through, you can hear chatter. Like this, like,
your senses are picking up.
You know
them
ones, they were like, yo, black, who's that? You know them ones, they're like, oh, awful plum tomatoes. You know what I'm saying? Like, who's that? Who's that? Then as I'm walking through, this brother comes out and says, shit, bruv, let's just rob him, innit? I was like, yo.
You know what I'm saying? They're talking about me now.
Like, they're talking about me. So then I'm looking around, I'm thinking, they can't be talking about me. So obviously I'm walking. I heard, bruv, let's rob him. And then I see my boy, one of the guys that, you know, goes to my school. I said, yo, bruv, what you saying? You know me, cuz.
You want him bad.
You know what I'm saying?
Everyone can see
him. I said, I know him. You know what I'm saying?
The tightest group ever. Vice group.
That's when I knew. But those days, it was robbing a man. Like, that was like robbing a guy. But now it's like, to think that someone is looking to, like, kill you, just end your life. It's mad, and that's why, like, Justin's interview was so powerful to us, you know what I mean? And that's why we're doing this podcast, you know what I'm saying? Things like that, that's why it's important to get the message out there.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
It's very true.
Get the message out there, man, and that's why we're doing this podcast, you know, that's why us three got together.
Mm.
This same house.
Remember them parties back then?
The same house as what, Kevin? What happened in this yard, bro?
The best house parties in North West London.
That's how we all met, man.
Yeah,
that's when the three of us were all together in the house. Mm. Obviously, Eli used to throw these big parties. Obviously, when my man Eli was gone, he saw the opportunity to change the room around and you'll be surprised at what he did.
It's crazy because, like, when I came back to this room, I didn't even recognize this room. I think, there was no way the party's in this room. There's no way, but it was. It's crazy.
It was mad, yeah, man. Like, obviously, every time my mum went Ghana, I'll throw a big yard party for the man them. And, you know, Kevin, obviously, me and Kevin, if you don't know, we're cousins, we're related. Really and truly, I'm his uncle.
He's not.
Really and truly, I'm his uncle.
Scrap that.
You know what I'm saying? But we're just going to say cousins, and then obviously, you two.
Yeah, man, we where did we meet? College.
Yeah, so obviously funny story with that one, innit?
Yeah, a little bit stuff.
We both got released from our former attendances.
Something like that, yeah.
And
we got asked not to come back, sort of thing.
Yeah, so I went to a college and then I see this guy walking through with his dad. I'm thinking, who's this guy, bro? Who comes to go register with his dad, bro?
Someone who's in trouble,
but yeah. So obviously I saw him and he knew a few guys that I knew that would also.
Yeah, so that was the mad thing, though, because like when I was going to go like high school and stuff like that, like a lot of the guys from like around where you live, they came to my uni, my high school.
Okay, yeah.
So like I used to always hear like like Kevin's name come up in conversations, stuff like that. So that was like mad, so like kind of bumping into him or meeting him at college as well, it was a bit crazy and stuff like that.
And then obviously, fate had it, he was in my class. And I remember kind of sitting there, no joke, like I was sitting there and then obviously I see him coming, I was like, yeah, at least someone I kind of know, innit? Do you know what I mean? Because it's always daunting starting
starting fresh, with no college. With exactly. Friends,
yeah. So it was good to obviously see someone else that I knew, and then literally from that day, formed sort of like a bond, innit? Yeah.
But this is where we met, and I'll never forget Kevin grinding that girl. You know. Kevin was doing all this like. You know what I mean? Like stuck in traffic. Kevin was grinding.
The mark is still there.
The mark is still there, ladies and gentlemen. It's still there. You know what I'm saying?
No weapon formed against me shall prosper. The eyes of this man shall not prosper.
Bro, Kevin was living life. Yeah,
some memories in life. Some memories.
Yeah, man. And Carl, I remember Carl was just drunk.
Hammer that was sticking his head out the window for air.
That was 11 years ago.
That was a long time ago.
11 years ago.
But that, like, I mean, this was like the beginning of my house party life, sort of.
Swear.
Yeah, man. Right.
Oh, so what? I introduced you to the dark side.
Yeah, still. They went downhill from there, innit?
I mean,
but no, it's obviously there were so many issues that we've been speaking about.
Yeah.
Me and Carl, for example. We've spoken on many different issues. Me and Eli have spoken on many different issues, and obviously sharing our ideas and just how interesting the points that are being made from the opposing person.
Yeah,
you know, we just thought, you know, why not come together and actually try and tackle these issues by sharing our points of views.
Yeah,
the way that we share them when we're talking to each other.
Well exactly, because I think if we're having a conversation, someone else must be having this conversation.
Absolutely.
And you know, it's good that we can share it with other people.
Absolutely.
And they can hear our point of views and stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Nah, for real. I mean, following on from what you said, a lot of the things Justin was talking about in his interview touched on lots of issues.
Yeah.
It wasn't just about youth crime, knife crime. You know, it was about, you know, social deprivation, cultural issues, education.
Village mentality.
Mentality, retribution, mental health. Yeah, you know, when you start talking about taking his son to therapy. You know, a lot of these things are the issues that are currently going on within our community, if not society.
But we don't see it. And we don't notice it. We don't act fast enough. It's sort of like we're being...
We're waiting for it to go wrong before we decide that we want to do something about it.
The three amigos are going to help to tackle these issues by bringing different topics to you. But obviously, if there's a topic that you guys feel like you want us to touch upon or you want to hear a viewpoint of a specific person, send it forward to us on our Instagram, 3's the Social, Twitter, 3's the Social.
On the website, which we'll tag.
Exactly. Yeah, for real.
And even drop a comment on the YouTube as well, man.
Exactly, and obviously we'll look to tackle those points or those topics that you sent to us.
Yeah, man. Like definitely. Like, subscribe.
Share it.
Email us.
Everybody.
3's the Social.
Welcome to 4's the Party. This is a section of the podcast where we read out requests that you sent to us. Okay, so please send in more requests. We're happy to answer any questions that you may have from topics from whatever, from relationships to sex to whatever. We're here to answer all your questions and give our insights. It makes our show more entertaining. So 3's the Social.
Okay, so we had our first, what you call it, a request, if you like.
First request, come on. Request
from none other than Janaika. Sorry if I'm saying your name wrong. So I'm going to put this kind of question to you guys and see what you guys think.
Yeah, man. Come on.
So she said that she's been in a relationship for 4 months.
Yeah.
As men, what are the signs to know it's right to call him the one? Can you talk about your experience if you guys have had one?
Jeez, that's a big question. You know?
It's a big question.
Mad thing.
It is.
And it's difficult to answer as well.
I mean, look, it is and it's not.
Yeah.
I guess... It depends on what side of the coin you're looking at it from.
Yeah.
So, you're together and you've been together for 4 months. How long were you dating for before you got together?
That's my question actually, because is this 4 months the dating period?
But she said they're together, isn't it?
In a relationship.
Let's take it for the words that I've said, isn't it? You know what I mean? And I guess if you look at it from the other side, if they were dating for 1 month and then they said, oh, let's just get together, then. Yeah. I guess it will be difficult for you to call him the one, but again, how much time do you spend with this person?
Yeah,
it's true.
Because if if I'm talking about my own scenario,
yeah.
I feel like 4 months isn't enough time to quantify someone being the one for you that you're going to spend. Because many times, people have fleeting thoughts, innit? Do you see what I'm saying? In the sense that you may be with someone, but the other person doesn't want to be there and they're, you know, thinking about something else. Mm.
It's true. I totally agree. I think you both have to be aligned. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, everything that you're thinking in terms of, like, where you're going to be in the future, he almost has to be thinking... Aligned. Yeah, it just has to be aligned because, like... Boy, like, right now, you don't know what sort of, like, relationship it is. Is it a casual thing?
Yeah.
Is it something that you're working towards, you know what I mean? Or is it just like, look, let's be real. We know her intentions, innit?
Yeah,
exactly. We don't know what the guy's thinking.
Anything, though.
It might just be a beating thing. It might just be a real thing, you know what I'm saying?
Bro, real Eli come out there.
you know what I mean?
So, I think it's important. I think it's dependent on, like, on whether he's made his intentions clear.
Mm.
I don't think he has, because then she wouldn't be asking.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm thinking.
Exactly. That's it.
So maybe his mind is in the same place as she has.
Yeah, exactly. Because look, as guys, we're simple. We're simple people.
Let's speak for yourself.
I understand what I mean. Yeah, I'm not talking about like what we think about. But in terms of our emotions, we're very simple people. Mm. Obviously, there are exceptions, but I guess if we're talking about us, you know, if we're not ready for that, we'll kind of make it clear we're not ready for that.
Yeah,
do you understand what I'm saying?
The thing is, like, I agree with you, but some women, they either don't pick it up or refuse to accept it.
Yeah, but if they refuse to accept it, then it's their own feelings that are going to get hurt. Do you understand?
Yeah.
I mean, if you've made your intentions clear, like, yo, look, I'm not ready for that right now.
Mm.
Let's keep on doing what we're doing.
Yeah.
And you're forcing him. Like, do you know what I mean?
But at the same time, though, like, do you know what? Carl, you're married, innit?
Yeah.
Boom. You know, how long have you been with your missus for?
Oh, God. It's been 8 years, man.
Man, I had to think about that.
Eight years
in the dunya. In the dunya. You know what I mean? Blood. 8 years, yeah? So when did you feel like, boom, you know, she's the one for me? At what point in the relationship? What time?
I don't know when it was, but what I will say, there was a point where I thought, you know what? She might be actually the one, do you know what I mean?
Oh.
And I think that was around like 6 months into our relationship.
Okay. Yeah. What made you think that? Yeah, that's what I wanted to know.
So obviously, like you said, like in a short space of time, like 4 months for example. It depends on how much time you spend with each other.
Yeah.
You to know. So like her parents actually live like less than 5 minutes driving from where
the way you drive? Of course it is.
I wasn't even driving when I met her though. You're in the room with that.
Oh yes!
That was a hot box
this. That's true love. No whip. You know what I mean?
But yeah man, so we used to spend like a lot of time together like that. And you know, like having got to know her family.
Yeah.
I was aware of her like her ambitions and her future plans. I thought, you know, like she's a sensible girl, like I mean like I could live with this for the rest of my life, sort of thing.
So that was you, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, let's hear about your wife's side.
Yeah.
When do you think that... Was she asking you questions?
First sight, man. She's like, you know what? These guys are right.
This is going to be bad.
These guys are right. You see me?
That's it.
Do you know what?
That's my...
I don't even want to heart the backstory too much, innit, yeah? But obviously, we saw her before.
Oh, what? Talking about college?
Yeah. And obviously, I remember the first time he saw her, you know, he almost got weak in the knees, you know? But no, he saw her and he was just like, wow.
Mm.
Like, yes.
Yeah.
And from that moment, it was more like, when is this going to happen?
Mm.
Pluck up the courage, let's go and chat to her, sort of thing.
Yeah.
But I remember at the time, she was seeing someone at the time, wasn't it?
Yeah. I was asking her to do bad things.
Yeah, for real. Man, let go.
Yeah.
But anyways, back to Janika. Let's not divert. Let's not go off.
Janika, all I'll say is take time, innit? Mm. Don't try and rush the feeling of the one the thought of the one.
Yeah, no, but then that also begs the question, or ask the question rather.
Yeah.
How old is she? Because some people feel like they're running out of time, they're trying to find something real.
Yeah, but again, yeah, I think that's just subjective on the person, isn't it? To be fair.
Some people when they're hitting their like early 30s, they think you're raw.
I think that's the wrong way.
Because you shouldn't make decisions
based on where you are, exactly. And how old you are.
But either way, yeah. 4 months, she still needs to take her time.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah,
because I truly believe you'll never truly know someone. Mm. As in, like, every year that goes by, every month, you're learning something new.
Exactly.
Do you understand? Mm.
So after what time period do you say, you know what, I kind of know this person enough now?
I don't know. Again, it depends, isn't it? How much time do you spend with each other?
Yeah.
Mm. I mean, someone could tell you 6 months, I know her inside out. Mm. I know him inside out.
That's a lie.
Not, but people say that.
People say that. Look at them man on Love Island.
But see that, exactly.
Them man, they live with each other for like 24/7.
Yeah. 8 weeks.
Imagine
the people that have been there. 8 weeks. You know what I'm saying? They can truly say, you know what, I've seen this, but obviously you could put on a facade for that amount of time, but again, like, you've been with that person, you pick up their mannerisms, how they can behave and what they do. Yeah, do you understand? So, I guess what I'm trying to say is, time is everything.
Time.
And if you're spending enough time together, and you're getting enough FaceTime, I'm not talking phone calls, FaceTime, you know, where you're sitting face to face, then you need to... That's when I feel like it'll be natural.
The cameraman just did in a silly gesture back there, bro. FaceTime. You know, but you know what I'm saying?
It's true.
Look, what I'm saying is this. Hear what I'm saying. Give it time. Mm. I think use this time to get to know each other.
No, enjoy the moment. Don't even push it.
Every
relationship, whatever you know, every time you come across a person, it's a learning experience. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Enjoy the
learning.
If it's gonna happen, it's gonna happen.
That's what I'm saying. Exactly.
I guess we're all just saying the same thing, Jamaica. Take time, rest, enjoy your moment. Keep going. And you know, there's the moments. Keep going. Let's do that again. Obviously, you need to relax. And obviously, get to know him. Enjoy the moment.
Get to know him. Yeah. Get to know his intentions, his ambitions. That sounds alright.
You know what, guys? Thank you very much for tuning into this episode.
Yeah.
If you haven't watched the first episode again, please
go back and watch it.
Powerful. Honestly.
And obviously, Twitter, Instagram, 3's the social.
Like, share, subscribe.
The number 3 is the social.
The social, yeah.
3's the social.
The social.
Come on. And 4's the party.
Always.
Next episode, we've got a big one.
Yep.
So stay tuned. Subscribe, like, any requests, any questions.
Send them through, man.
Send them through. Email, Instagram, the whole shebang. 3's the social.
Do it all, man. We want to hear your requests. We want those topics. We want to tackle things that you want to know,
right,
as well as the topics that we've obviously chosen.
All right then.
Until
peace out.
Time, take easy.
3's social. One. Bang bang.
Just make sure it doesn't happen again.
I can't do it, can I?
No, you got it. You got that raspiness. You're trying to say it. You told it.
Through the fire, you keep holding on.
Why are you holding on to the thing though?
I'm holding myself together.
It's already stable.
You're not just chatting like that because you got data.
You ain't got internet?
I ain't got data, bro.
This big 2019.
Man, I finished all my data,
bro. Ask him how much data he has,
though. Why? Why?
Nah, my internet cut off for a good while.
How come he's 45 gig, bro?
Bro, a week and a half, bruv, and you're connecting to Netflix and shit like that.
Scared of your porn addiction.
No.
You took long to respond to that.
What the fuck is he asking? What's he asking? Yeah.